song was a big hit for Jerry Lewis, a man that's become known for his outstanding work with muscular dystrophy. I took my daughter Julie with me to visit one of my favorite charities last summer down in Jackson, Mississippi, the Willowood Developmental Center. It's a multi-purpose facility that provides education, therapy, vocational training, sheltered workplaces, and alternative living programs for the developmentally disabled children and adults of the area. I've worked with Willowood for the past 7 years, and I have the utmost respect and admiration for their staff, along with all the other people in this country who work so hard to help people with disabilities have a better quality life. One of the biggest events I've been involved with is the Entertainment for Education concert. This was started by my friend Sam Haskell, a vice president of the famous William Morris Talent Agency. Sam's from a little town of Amory, Mississippi. And for the last few years, he's asked his superstar friends and clients and some fellow Mississippians like me to help raise money for a scholarship fund in honor of his mother, who was Mississippi's first school nurse. At first, nobody could believe all these big stars were coming to Amory, Mississippi. People like Debbie Allen and Kathy Lee Gifford and Sandy Patty and Nell Carter. But they did. They stayed in the homes of the local people while we were there, and it's been a great experience for everybody concerned. No one gave more of his time to charity than Lawrence Welk, and he was an inspiration to all of us.
We'd like to pay tribute to a fine musician and band leader who has kept his great band going for almost 40 years, our good friend Woody Herman. Boys, let's hear the Woodchopper's Ball again. A one and two.